Hi, so we're still on Prismic Studio. And in the last video, we discussed different frameworks, what are the big families. And we think that maybe in this video, it's better like to give some kind of actions or advices on like which framework you should use depending on who you are and on your project.
Right. So because the whole video, we did it so that we can give some insight on how you choose frameworks for your next website. Mm-hmm. And since there are a lot of technologies, we explored this hierarchy, and yeah, maybe now down to the advice.
Okay.
So it's let's get the list of frameworks. You can use, right? Of course, you can use PHP frameworks, but here we're talking more about like maybe JavaScript ones.
Yes.
So you can use Node.js, a template one, or like the components ones, and then there are plenty of them. So you can use better React, or you can use Gatsby.
Next,
or Vue,
Nuxt, and Gridsome.
So these are the technology that we'll be talking about. So maybe the first thing, first thing you need to understand, do you want to go components or not? And why would you go for components? Well, if you have a big website, you want to share things between pages, you want to have, by sharing, you will have coherence, you have productivity. Well, you can use components for that. But it's quite some learning to do. You know, you need to learn about components, how to use them, that the actual framework of components. So I will go more deeper into maybe you can discuss it more, the component one, the choice of frameworks of that support components. But that's the first choice. Do you want to go components, or do you use like just simple templating? Honestly, simple templating works fine. It gets you results very quickly and works well. So you can use like Node.js with, I don't know, Express and your favorite templating system, and you'll be fine. You can do your website, you can finish it very, very quick. You know, even the performance is good. So that's a very viable choice.
And do you feel like components are something that is useful when you need to hand off the project to someone else? Because it's structured, it's more structured, so someone can more like find his way project.
I guess it's, I would say it's better if you want to use it to work in teams.
Mm-hmm.
So if you had different people working on the website, so several people work on the same page,
mm-hmm.
and then you can obviously have someone working on one part of the page and someone else on the other part of the page. Components make that easier, right? Because, you know, separation, and, you know, no one can break the result of the other, of course.
Okay, but you think sometimes it's kind of overkill of structure?
If you don't have to work as a team, and you don't want you don't care about, it's not a huge website, you don't have to go through all the reusability throughout pages, yeah, maybe it's an overkill. Some people would say it's an overkill. So that's the first thing. If you don't want to do something big, and you don't want to the overkill and the learning curve of components, well, just run for a simple templating system. Node.js works well with any, like, your favorite templating system. Now, if we go back to components, mm-hmm. and you were willing to learn that, if you have a prior experience in components, like if you know React, well, obviously we'll choose that, then you have to choose between
Next or Gatsby.
Because you need something that generates the HTML so that you're sure to get very good SEO. You know, because whenever Google will try to index your website, if the result is not there, it might deprioritize it, which is not very good. So next, Gatsby. Well, both, they provide more or less the same thing. They mm-hmm. give you this rendering. One of them does it on the server side. One does it at build time. The question here, do you want, when you press on the button, you know, you publish something new, you press on the button, do you want to wait until you see the result? Because if you take the build time, then whenever you press this button, it will regenerate the website.
Yes.
So there will be some delay. The delay might be quick, you know, it was because Gatsby, they optimized a lot the framework to generate very quickly,
mm-hmm.
but it might be a few seconds, maybe like up to maybe for very big websites, maybe like 20 seconds.
So you think it's more about like the developer experience at that point?
It's even the publisher, the marketing person or the copywriter.
Yeah,
when you publish something,
do you want
to wait? Of course, there is a preview system that allows you to have a quicker result, but still you have that. You need to consider that.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the aspects that you want to kind of take into account when you do your choice. Whereas in Next, it's just server rendering. So the page, whenever you request it, it will generate it on the fly and will get you. So that's much quicker. But it will be
slower for the first viewer,
right? Because then there is caching that kicks on, but the first request, it will take time. And then the other, once it's built, that's it. It's instantaneous because it's already there. You're getting just static files. So it's very quick. So that's when what makes, you know, a difference between these two frameworks.
And the ecosystem of plugins around Gatsby.
Obviously, right?
If you come from like, I don't know, you used WordPress at some point.
Certainly you should go for Gatsby. You know, if you come from WordPress and you want to use components, yeah, Gatsby is a very good choice there because, you know, it gives you not only the components, it gives you some kind of plugin system that allows you to improve your website. So if you see like you want to make images quicker, that's a plugin. If you want to make, deal differently with links, optimize things, you have a plugin for that. And that's very, very, very nice. Whereas Next is more open about this kind of thing, which is good. If you want to do things your way and choose your frameworks, well, Next will be good for that. For instance, for our own, we're doing like, you know, we use different technologies.
Mm-hmm.
But for instance, now we're experimenting with Next and it's working quite nicely. But I'm sure Gatsby would have been like very good choice as well. So
okay.
Yeah, it comes back to this. Do you want, I guess, for except other details, it comes back to the choice of, do you want to pay the delay on build time, meaning make copywriters wait until they see it, or do you want to generate it like on the fly? So one request maybe might pay the request itself, the generating, but then you have the caching and it will be very, very quick.
Which might be linked to like the frequency at which you change the contents in your website.
Yeah, if you change a lot, maybe building at build time, it slows copywriters. But, you know, different people have different opinions on this. So on the other side,
mm-hmm.
you have also a component one is like, as we said before,
Vue.js. Yes.
Vue tends to be very good at if people are starting with components. So they never did components before. They have some kind of, HTML and their DOM. They can progressively go from having DOM to having components. They add their JavaScript, they have their things. So it's not, let's start with React. You can take your current templating system and augment it slowly to get into components.
So for beginners, it's less like overwhelming. It's easier.
It's less overwhelming. Okay. There's a good learning, not very steep learning curve. That's very nice, especially if you use it with something like Nuxt. Because even if Vue is very easy to start with, there are a lot of configuration in the build and how you generate your website, all these kind of things. But Nuxt takes care of that. So if you start with Nuxt, you just name things as files. You know, you don't do routing, you don't do all of these kind of things. You rather make things like with WordPress, a file is a page, and you start working there, you put your HTML and start documenting it. So it's a very good choice if you want to learn components and you didn't before, it gives you that kind of framework.
Okay, very clear.
So these are different things to consider when you're choosing your framework for your website.
Okay, well, I hope that's going to be useful. And in the next video, we'll look at more CMSs and can try to have the same conversation about CMSs.
Right.